Welcome this great Easter morning as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord together. I look forward to being in worship with you today and celebrating this wonderful experience with you. Some key words today, alleluia. We're going to be looking for alleluias throughout, and so we'll begin with that right now. Alleluia, Christ is risen, and the response is he is risen indeed. Alleluia. So let us try that right now. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. Let us begin worship.
Before we do, we have just a couple quick announcements. One, there's a sign-up board out there for the Fifth Sunday potluck. It's on April 30th. And then also, VBS dates have been set June 26th through 30th. So get that on your calendar.
Let us pray. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Our Lord is risen. The stone has been moved away. He is with us. Let us run to meet him in Galilee. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Is
Please rise and join in singing. Living together in trust and hope, we proclaim our faith. We believe in one God,
creator of all there is, and all things seen and unseen, heard and unheard. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's begotten Son, who came to bring us new light and new life. This new fire was born to the Virgin Mary, lived and taught in our was crucified for us, died for us, and rose from the tomb for us. He reigns over all creation and will come again. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who lives in every breath we take and fills us with sacred presence. In this we will have a resurrected life in this world and life everlasting in the next.
Oh, Africa sings a new song, reaching out with a new hallelujah. Every son and every daughter, everyone sing a new hallelujah.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another.
Glorious God, we continue to wander from your ways and your will. We continue to do those things which we ought not to do, hardening our hearts. Roll back the great stone from our hearts. Sustain us with the grace and power of the empty tomb. Guide us to a risen life in your presence, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died and rose again for us. Amen.
Peace be with you, my brothers and sisters. In baptism, you have received a spirit of adoption. You are God's beloved children. In the name of Christ, your sins are forgiven. Rejoice and welcome this freedom as a gift. Amen.
Your power.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Let us share Christ's peace with one another. Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Okay, peace be with you. Peace be with you. God's peace be with you. Peace be with you. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord. I'd like to invite the children forward for a message at this time. Before you get too settled there, I actually need you to come back further with me today. We're going to come all the way up here. Yep. I've got a message that's going to be just for you. So I'm actually going to turn off my microphone a little bit, and you're all just going to have a discussion between your selves, okay? So we're going to have a little brief message, and I need you to follow me back here. We're going to keep this secret for just a moment, okay? So yeah, come on, let's gather around. We're going to get behind. And suddenly there was a great earthquake. A great earthquake. In a way, it's kind of like the notifications I get on my phone. Whenever there's a big earthquake anywhere in the world, I get a notice about it right here. You see, now living somewhat as I am now between Oklahoma and the New Madrid Fault, it sort of seemed like a good idea to add an earthquake app to my phone. So I get notifications all the time. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake. It's actually the second notification that Matthew gives us out of his gospel of a big earthquake. The last one came just a week ago during the telling of the Passion story. Matthew then described that earthquake as occurring at the moment of Jesus' death on the cross. What Matthew wrote was, "At that moment, the earth shook, and the rocks were split open, and the tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised." A bit scary, yeah? Now again today, another tomb is opened up. Jesus' own tomb is opened. And suddenly, there is a great earthquake. I like that Matthew felt like he needed to add the word suddenly there in his description. As if our experience of earthquakes might be anything other than sudden. As our modern day angels, messengers in the form of apps and tweets and reporters and news anchors, as they're all quick to inform us with their own breaking notifications, big earthquakes are still part of our world. And they are always, always abrupt, unexpected, rapid, and sudden. And they still bring fear into our lives. As the people of Japan or New Zealand or Haiti or California or Oklahoma or even St. Louis might tell us, no matter how much we prepare, analyze, or try to predict those earthquakes, they're always sudden. They always bring fear. But for Matthew, as he tells us today, it's not about the destructive power of an earthquake that matters most. No. Instead, it's the fact that the natural world itself, well, the natural world can't help but give witness to God's action in our lives through Jesus. That earthquake is the way of the world saying, Amen. Through the power of an earthquake, we learn from Matthew that Christ's death and resurrection make a difference. They make a difference to his disciples, to both the first women and to the men. They make a difference to the world, to the living, and to the dying. Indeed, Christ's death and resurrection make a difference to the whole of creation, to the whole cosmos. Through the power of earthquakes, Matthew shows that the cross and the empty tomb are together the pivot point on which all of history turns. They are the pivot point by which God acts to thrust God's creation, all of it, including us, into a new life with which death cannot overshadow. Now that's news that certainly contradicts the normal pictures of the effects of earthquakes in our world, isn't it? What do those usual pictures bring to us? Images of destroyed homes, damaged schools and hospitals, churches and community centers broken, people and pets lost amid the rubble, search teams, rescue efforts, heroic sacrifices, and lives brought to an end. Those images, those pictures of earthquakes, they can beg us to ask the question, what difference does the resurrection make? What difference? Jesus is risen, so what? Our modern day messengers, well, this is where they're often at a loss. But God's messenger today, that angel of the Lord, he opens for us at least a portion of the answer, the so what. It's in the message that he gives. He is going ahead of you. He, the crucified one, has been raised from the dead, and he is going ahead of you. That is the difference. This is the so what. Jesus is risen and is going ahead of us in our joys and our sorrows, in our hopes, in our disappointments. Jesus is going ahead of us in our loves and our losses, in our living and in our dying. Jesus goes ahead of us. Now, the women at the tomb, they encounter the reality of this message immediately. It comes just like the earthquake itself, rapidly, abruptly, unexpectedly. And as they are running to tell the others, suddenly, Jesus is there. Not just in front of them, but actually before them, ahead of them. Jesus is there, ahead, stepping into the gaps created by the earthquakes of our lives, leading us on paths out of destruction, showing us the way to a place of healing. Jesus is already there, ahead, waiting for them, waiting for us. And the first word he gives is greetings. Greetings. Now, unfortunately, I think that the word that we use here, greetings, has lost a lot of its effect. If you look up that word in an online dictionary known as the Urban Dictionary, what you'll find there is this definition. Greetings is used by many beings, including aliens and abnormal people. Greetings. Yeah. Well, Jesus, through baptism, is our brother. Jesus is our teacher. Jesus is our Lord. He is certainly no alien to us. So I don't think that's the kind of greetings that he meant. The Urban Dictionary goes on to say, it's used to say hello while confusing other people, normally into silence. Well, that's not what greetings, at least the way Jesus means it, is either. He wants us to go tell. He wanted the Marys to go and tell others. It's not about confusing us into silence. So maybe we need another way to express this greeting. how could we do it? Well, we could stick in the Urban Dictionary and look for something like yol or tsup. Just seem a little too casual to me. We could borrow something, maybe some brothers and sisters around the world. We could look to Austria, southern Germany, for example, and get something like Grüßgott. Can you say that with me? Grüßgott. Grüßgott. That has a suddenness to it, right? A snap. Yeah. It means salute to God. That's what's behind that. That kind of begins to get there. Or maybe we could look to our Slavic brothers and sisters and borrow one of their words for greeting. Zdravstvuyte. Can you do that one? Zdravstvuyte. That's almost an earthquake in and of itself, isn't it? Yeah, certainly is on my tongue. Okay. Those words, well, maybe they begin to get there. Now, I know Jesus probably wouldn't have been speaking any of those. He would have been talking in Aramaic, and I have no idea what that word would be. But I think whatever it was, however he would have said it, he would have said it in a way that carries the same kind of impact with the suddenness and the fullness of an earthquake. He would have said that word, greetings, like it makes a difference. This is what we see following the crisis of death. We see earthquakes. We see God raising the dead to new life. We see an empty tomb, a sign of Jesus' resurrection. We see an angel giving us the message, he is going ahead of you. And then we see Jesus himself, already there, already alive, already greeting us, embracing us with the strength of life. Greetings. Grüßgott. Zdravstvuyte. What's up? Of course, none of those words capture just how fully, just how completely Jesus is here to greet us this day. Happily, very happily, we have one more word, one more way of saying it. It's a word that greets and embraces. It's a word that lives and helps us to say this so fully and so deeply. It's a word with the power of a life-changing earthquake. And it's a word you already know. Can I get anyone to help me with it? Any guesses? Oh, you know it. Hallelujah. 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 Everybody, say it together. One, two, three. Alleluia! Alleluia! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Amen.
Please rise and join in singing as we share our tithes and offerings.
See when it lays.
rejoicing in the risen life of Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. We pray for the church. Unite all Christians in our shared calling to proclaim the gospel. Raise up women and men to serve as faithful leaders. Make us bold witnesses to the resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. For the earth, renew your creation with seasonable weather and growth. Protect plants and animals from the damage of excessive heat, drought or flooding, windstorm or hail. Lord, in your mercy. For the nations, bring peace to communities torn apart by warfare. Guide all refugees to safety. Bolster the courage of those who put themselves in danger to preserve the lives of others. Lord, in your mercy. For those in need, shelter the homeless. Protect those who suffer abuse or neglect. Befriend the lonely. Give peace to the dying, comfort to the bereaved, and heal the sick, especially Henry, Ron, Jeff, Ed, Ivy Ruth, the Amaretta McGee family, John, Janet, Pat, Jennifer, Jeannie, the Cass family, Claudia, Mark, Shirley, Willie, Pat, Chris, Kim, Cliff, Lisa, Debbie, Audrey, Nellie, Steve, Marietta, and all those we now name. Lord, in your mercy. For this assembly, free us from fear and renew us in faith. Bless the newly baptized, those who seek to know your love, and all who come to your holy table. Lord, in your mercy. With thanksgiving, we remember those who have died, especially Keith, Violet, and Wayne, and all who yearn for the fulfillment of your Easter promise of resurrection and life. Lord, in your mercy. Joining our voices with your faithful ones of every time and every place, we offer our prayers in the name of the risen one, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your Spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith, saying together, "Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again." O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence as we cry out, "Come, Holy Spirit." Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth, burning with justice, peace, and love, as we shout out, "Come, Holy Spirit." With your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God, blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now let us feast this Easter day on Christ, the bread of heaven. Alleluia.
Did you? They nailed him to
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. God has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless you and raise you to life both now and forever. Amen. Alleluia! Christ is risen. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Serve the risen Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.